Thank you for joining me in this short video on network orchestration. My name is Hans van der Straten. I am with Nokia and we are working with the team on what is called virtual networks orchestration. Virtual networks orchestration is about two aspects. The first aspect is cloud. We are living with this set of activities in the cloud as we all are consuming on our smartphones all the applications that are living somewhere in these big data centers. The second part of what we are working is connectivity. Connectivity is about bringing to make sure that all these data centers, cloud to cloud to cloud, are very well connected through, while you as an enterprise live in your own enterprise virtual private network. What we will be showing here is basically a setup where we are going to connect a number of clouds from a connectivity perspective. And through that, make sure that Amazon Web Services is the public cloud service provider that we use here as an example, that you can start consuming services in that public cloud from within your enterprise VPN. That's a clue. So let's basically take us for a step, for a second, into the application. The application is called CloudBand Network Director, and CloudBand Network Director allows you to execute in a very, I would dare calling it, smart way, including workflow manager, resource control, and a whole set of plugins, basically to allow you to basically execute a number of, let's say, commands and scripts that are collected together in a so-called NSD. So let me show you that for 1 second. We have CloudBand Network Director here, basically that, first of all, allows you to execute the NSDs that you can find here, and we will show them in a second how they look like. The second key part of that engine is these blue dots, basically, that act as the plugins to call out into all the networking devices that the system will encounter along the way in order to make sure that you can find, as an enterprise, your services in Amazon Web Services. As an enterprise, you will be able to steer the settings across the whole chain, across Nuage, across the underlying network services platform, in this case as an example, and the 7750 service router that acts as a data center gateway, basically to complete a so-called service chain, in this case over a FortiGate firewall, into Amazon Web Services. In this example, we will show that also that not only the connectivity will be set up in a very dynamic way, but at the same time that also the FortiGate firewall will be installed as part of the whole set of activities. So to make it short, in the example that in the demo that we will be running here, basically in the data center first, there is literally nothing. There is no network, there is no virtual network function, there is no FortiGate. And in the example that we will be using here, we will set it up in a very dynamic way, step by step, with as an end result the fact that you can, from within your enterprise VPN, connect into Amazon Web Services, connect into your specific part of Amazon Web Services. Okay, so basically, so let me take you for 1 second to that screen that allows you to access Amazon Web Services. And as you can see here, we are going to basically activate the URL to get into your specific instance of Amazon Web Services. And as you can see, the connection has been timing out with a problem, with signaling a problem in loading the page. The reason why this is very simple. There is simply no connectivity yet into Amazon Web Services, into that public cloud. So what we first will do is we will show you how that NSD network service descriptor looks like. A network service descriptor is, first of all, a very simple English written text file, as you can see here. We have a structure in the text file with a number of indentations that allows the program to read the structured text file. The second thing that you see here is you see a dot notation, nokia.nuage.nodes.enterprise as an example, where basically out of this structure, the system will know where to look for which kind of a plugin. It's what is called an object-oriented notation that is very structured and hierarchical and allows you to basically execute the right commands starting from the right object. The last point that is important for this very short introduction is basically to you are allowed as a network programmer basically to define a number of dependencies and relationships between your objects. To make it short, you as a network architect, you will be allowed in this so-called TOSCA file, you will be allowed to explain that you first have to do something on the service router, get that parameter back out of the service router, to then give that parameter into the Nuage data center, the VSD of Nuage. All these relationships between your network objects and therefore your physical network devices in the network, you will be able to specify in this English written text. So as a final point on these network services, network service descriptors, you will see that in order to be able to read this file, that you really will need to know what you're talking about from a networking perspective, because it talks about Nuage Enterprise as an example. It talks about Nuage Domain a little bit deeper. Here you find Nuage Domain. These are wordings that are known to a network architect that is very well aware of Nuage. So on the one hand, from an IT perspective, it's called a YAML file, but you don't need to know the software language behind it. What you do need to know, however, is basically how your network looks like and what the components are that you have in your network and how to work with these components. So therefore, all this setup is really focused towards network architects to allow them to define these network services themselves without having to go to software specialists. If this is the NSD that we just highlighted, let us now go to the CloudBand Network Director platform. For the sake of this short demo, we already have deployed a number of branches, and indeed you do see that the NSDs have been structured. If I go back to the PowerPoint, what we will do is we will set up the private cloud data center. We will set up a first branch that you find here. And then we basically will set up a branch to Amazon Web Services. Therefore, we have deconstructed or decomposed the problem statement of an end-to-end service chain into parts that you will set up one by one and then literally stitch them together to get an end-to-end service chain running. So let's go and take a look at CloudBand Network Director. Now here you see that we already have deployed two branch offices and one data center. It's called here as our experts data center. So what we now will do is we will basically set up that last branch, which is called Amazon Virtual Private Network. And for that, we basically have to create that new instance. And I'm going to do this fast, AWS branch. We do select a Vim. In this case, it's the Liberty release still. And then we have a number of tenants in our laboratories in Antwerp. Basically, we select it here as our experts. So like this, you are going to set up a number of items as input to your network service descriptor. Then you can press deploy, and the system will start deploying. As you can see now, we can actually follow up the progress of the execution of the text file, the network service descriptor that you have seen a second ago, basically by going into the jobs. And then you find the child jobs. You will see that he starts executing one by one, and it again will be a very structured flow as you have specified as a network designer in the NSD. We will come back on the progress as I'm going further through the presentation. So basically, as currently this Amazon Web Services branch network service distributor is executing, as you can see here on the screen, let's go back for a second and double check what has happened in with the other network service descriptors. As an example, in the data center domain, we have executed a number of steps that I can highlight here. First, you will recognize a number of networks that basically have been executed upon and installed as part of the network service descriptor. The second part that you see here is called a little bit in the keywording here, firewall_VNF. This is the actual VNF that will basically that will be, act as the firewall that will be installed as part of the service chain inside the data center. And then last, you will see that the firewall has a number of vPorts and redirection targets connected to it. In other words, the firewall becomes part of that newly installed network inside the data center. All this literally as part of the service chain, basically automatically as part of that network service being installed. So three items that we need to take a short look at now as currently the network service descriptor for Amazon Web Services branch is still executing. The first item is that we did go in one of the branches before, we did go to what is called the network services platform that you recognize basically here in this PowerPoint. The network services platform actually acts as the API giving access to the full one SDN, a whole collection of SRs, service switches, under the NSP. So basically the whole underlay, as such we don't talk to, but we do take pick up the two endpoints at both sides of the underlay through NSP to connect them into the overlay. That's basically the front end into the NSP, and here actually the cross-profile silver was set in the NSD as part of this API call. The other item that I would like to emphasize here is the fact that, as an example, in the SR Experts basically network that has been set up in the data center, there are a number of domains defined. The one was called the data center domain. And in under that data center domain, there are a whole number of networks literally installed in a software-defined way in the overlay, as it is then called, as part, again, of the execution of the network service descriptor. It was not there before. And then you do see, as an example, that there is a private management network. This is called a management subnet. And this is a totally different network from, for instance, the public internet network that is egress side, basically, at the firewall that allows to escape out from the enterprise VPN into the public internet. And then the last is basically a management plane, and then a forwarding plane here called My Private. The essence is therefore that when installing a firewall inside a data center, you do install a whole collection of networks, not just one single network, and you have to connect them all through and or carefully separate them, layer 2, layer 3, security domains, and so on and so forth. All that perfectly possible through Nuage, but automated out from the network service descriptor. The third and last item that I would like to bring you to, so basically the second item was Nuage DC SDN that I've just highlighted now, is how this call into the 7750 looks like. So let's take a short look at that one. Here you do see basically PE25 is actually the router that is running in the Antwerp labs on which we are doing this, and you do see that we basically have set up, in this case, as part of the example, to terminate the GRE tunnel for a given branch, basically, to activate a number of VPRNs to allow, basically, to have that, in this case, CPE, that is a legacy device connected over layer 2, to become a layer 3 device as part of the enterprise VPN inside the data center. So that's basically giving just a small representation of the commands that we give onto the 7750 service router. So in the meanwhile, let's double check where we are with the status of the branch. It is deploying still. Let's take a look at the events log. And you do see that currently there are a number of, again, ingress ACL is a keyword that a network architect is supposed to know. It's all our items that are being set up and part of the NSD, written inside the NSD, as part of the network design that the network architect has brought together. As this is currently executing, let's now go to the virtual machine that is basically running at the far end of the branch, and to try to access from the far end of the branch, basically, this Amazon Web Services instance of Nuage. You do see it still has not connected, but I would hope and trust now that we are getting through the execution and that then we will be able to access AWS. So let's go back now basically to our web page where we can access from one of the branch offices, the Amazon Web Services branch. And if things go well, we should now be able to, let's first double check the execution status. So it has been deployed AWS branch, as you can see here. And if we then go further into the events log, then you do see that basically the last interface indeed was a bridge interface to connect the branch onto the data center. So if we now go back and try to ping through the URL, basically your Amazon Web Services instance of your enterprise into Amazon Web Services, then we should be able to see that basically there is a connection onto the virtual private cloud instance that you have instantiated as an enterprise in Amazon. So far for this demo, so what we have been able to show, let me just summarize in one more second, is that a number of branches have been added to the enterprise VPN. We basically have connected into a private cloud where a FortiGate was installed as part of the service chain, and from where you then could connect into your instances of Amazon Web Services, all as part of a set of network service descriptors. So let me now take you back to these network service descriptors for a few concluding remarks. Basically, the key message remains, this is about English, but where the complexity really is in the network design. You are going to use here Nuage, SROS APIs, NSP APIs, and all other networking APIs that you would want to access to finish up your service chain end to end. And the whole intent, therefore, of this activity around virtualized network orchestration is about giving the design of a network service back to network architects without any intervention of other software specialists that have to know all the in-depth software technologies that are behind that system. This is about giving network services design back to network architects. Thank you for your attention.